After over a 6-month campaign, working on my drawings from second grade, finally won the majority of the vote for the Saturday Topics poll. Yep, I am not that excited to make this video. I really am not, because I'm not just showing my drawings from second grade. No, I'm going to be showing you all a picture book I drew in second grade. That magic mohawk. And on the back cover, where the description of books usually go, I instead put this image of me looking like E.T. Once there was a kid named Bull Boy. He wanted to have a mohawk because he wanted to be cool. So he went to the magic barber. Yeah, apparently, back then, I thought the name Bull Boy was cool. I don't even know if Bull Boy is a name. For anyone who's named Bull Boy out there, please, just say so down in the comments. Tell me if your name is Bull Boy. He asked the barber, "Can I have the best mohawk in the world?" The barber said, "Ooh, that easy. It's a magic mohawk." Bull Boy yelled, "I want one of those." "Okay," said the barber. Yep, before I even saw Higurashi, I already did fan art for Irie. Then Bull Boy sat on a chair. The barber dyed his hair purple. Stick? Bull Boy hair with gel. Then he put magic dust on Bull Boy's hair. Then he said, "Done." Bull Boy walked out of the store. I'm just really, really concerned about this freaking barber I drew. Like, what the hell is he? He went home. He said, "I got a new mohawk." "That's great," said his cats. Then he brushed his teeth and went to bed. He has good hygiene. So it looks like he's washing his hands or, you know, trying to, you know, remove his head from his absolutely large neck. He dreamed he was beating up Kevin. What did Kevin do to you? And Bull Boy won. His magic mohawk turned blue. So yeah, apparently he could turn colors whenever it feels like it. The next day, Bull Boy went to school. When he walked in the room, he saw a chicken leg hit the wall. He immediately knew who did it. Kevin the Clockbreaker. Kevin the Clockbreaker. Oh, man. Kevin walked up to Bull Boy. He said, "Fight Toroyu at 3. "What?" said Bull Boy. Kevin walked to his seat. Yes, because, that's definitely what happens. Just Kevin throwing chicken legs at the wall, breaking clocks, and telling people to fight him the next day. What? I have amazing characters. Like, I used to write such enthralling characters back then. At recess, nerds were giving Bull Boy first aid kits. One said, "Kevin." Kevin fighting you. Yeah, I could not read it. I can barely read what's on this page. Gosh. One said, "Kevin fighting you because he thinks your hair is dumb." The night before the fight, Bull Boy, he wished to grow 4 feet and 8 inches. Ah, man. 4 feet, 8 inches. Definitely an intimidating height. He grew that tall. Then he wished he had $1 billion. Now, I don't know about you, but this nerd, I feel really bad for him. Like, I feel really bad for him. Like, he has a huge and terrible case of acne. He has a huge and terrible case of acne, and, from the way this is, you know, from the time this was written, I probably had intended for these characters to be in second grade, so for this guy to have, that much acne in second grade, Whew. Gotta feel really bad for him. Gotta feel really bad for him. When it was lunch, he opened his Swiss cheese, and he saw on the wrapper $1. The Swiss cheese gives him $100. He got $100 of Swiss cheese. And it said, no, the dollar is not real. The dollar's not real, but at least it just says, you won $1 billion! Oh yeah, baby, he yelled. Be quiet, said the principal. But I won lots of $$. Then the principal. Boo boy won $1 million, not the principal. Not the principal. What? I am shown scanned images of each and every one of these pages, but what? Even with the scan I'm showing on screen, and you know, physically showing, I'm not joking. That was the way I wrote that. I have no clue. What is happening? So apparently, Bull Boy opened a Swiss cheese wrapper. There was a dollar bill inside of it. He yelled, "Woohoo!" And the principal walked up, saying, "Hey, be quiet." And then the principal's like, "Wait a second. Now I won a bunch of money. Like, isn't it Bull Boy who's supposed to win the money, not the fucking principal?" And for some reason, it's John's birthday. Happy birthday, John. What that, said Bo Boy. That is, that a wishing well, said Bob. Now there's a wishing well? There was actually a wishing well in there. The nurse said, I put it in there. Bob accidentally went in his pants. So you're telling me, this nurse right here installed a wishing well in the middle of their lunch, in the middle of their lunchroom. And for some reason, that made a character named Bob pee his pants? First off, why would a nurse install a wishing well inside of a cafeteria? Why would a nurse install a wishing well inside of a lunchroom? And also, what does this have to do with the plot? Then he ran the Sorge closet. He ran the Sorge closet. Everyone was loofing? How was... Did no one spell check me? No one spell checked me! As long as I'm able to write the letters in English correctly, it's all good! Why was there no spell check? I know this is me in second grade. I'm not gonna have the best spelling or grammar. But why did no one help me with the spelling or grammar of this book? I'm sorry, but at least for the spelling, I could have had some direction. At Pete Kevin. Was laughing at Pete Kevin? Is that supposed to be except Kevin? He walked up to Bo Boy. He said, Taro, I'm gonna knock you out. Bo Boy was frantic. I peed my pants. That night, Bo Boy had a nightmare. It was about the magic mohawk fell off. I just gave up on grammar here. He got to go to the hospital. Wow. So, my mohawk fell off, and I get the reward of going to the hospital. The next day, Kevin won the first round. There's multiple rounds of this fight, apparently. The mohawk fell off Bull Boy, but Bull Boy knowed out Kevin. and he made a book about him beating up Kevin. Kevin beat up Bullboy Loyo. It's a masterpiece of an ending. It's a masterpiece of an ending. You know? You know? That's a masterpiece. The Magic Mohawk? A masterpiece.
Okay.